Hi, how are you again? This is Dr. Tony from Planned Pethood. We're gonna review very quick about heartworm disease, something that we have in the last study from the vet hospital, from the vet school, in 10 to 15% in stray dogs. So it's something really common in this environment. Like we reviewed before, we have three main groups of parasites. We already reviewed about ticks and fleas. We already mentioned before about intestinal parasites, but we're gonna take a very important look what is heartworm disease. This is a very common disease in the tropical environments. It's very transmittable. The vector of the transmission is a mosquito, okay? What happens with the mosquito? The mosquito sucks somebody else's blood, definitely a dog or a cat, and he sucks a very, very tiny worms in the blood. Then what happened, it just goes through our pet, inject them, and the parasite, the little tiny parasites, get circles in the blood for 6 months. After the 6 months, it just goes straight to the heart and just get in a long, an adult way worm, and we call heartworm adult parasite. This is very important disease. This is the adult that you're gonna identify, or we identify in some necropsies. The adult, the male one, can measure even 30 centimeters into the heart. What is happening? What is the bad part of this disease? It's a very slow disease, and it doesn't show signs until they're 8, 9, or 10 years old, and they start coughing, they start having exercise intolerance, and we see some kind of weird signs in the dogs. Definitely they come, we rule out some diseases, and then we get in the final diagnosis of this disease. It's treatable when we get it in the first stages. It's not treatable when they get really old and they get really sick. And the main thing of the parasites is just get into the heart, and they just start growing and multiply on it. And it can go through the pulmonary artery. It's like an obstruction into the heart, and definitely the heart gets enlarged by time, and definitely that's the main sign in this disease. We're going to talk about how to prevent it in this weather, and something that you really, really need to be aware before coming or being in this kind of tropical weathers. There is many ways to prevent about our dogs and cats. Probably you have seen this in the last videos. Okay, we have something that we call monthly treatment or monthly prevention treatment, and it can include either just an ampoules, can be Revolution, that is salamictin, and we apply it once a month in our pets, and they protect against internal worms, but mainly against the heartworm disease. And the other one, we can use tablets that in Mexico is called Cardomec, and the States and Canada is called Hargard. Okay, and we give them to one pill a month. It's very, very tasty, very yummy pill, and the dogs can get it once a month all the time. Okay, the other way to take care of this disease is just to come every 4 to 5 months, because we just review the full cycle of the parasites is to be an adult of 6 months. So we need to do it before he gets an adult way. So you need to come or to your vet every 4, maximum 5 months, just to apply or inject a product that is called ivermectin, that is good against to kill the little tiny worms that we were talking about.